Americans. It also means taking their fur babies along for the ride. Do you do that? 3 in 4 vacationers say they will bring their pets on a road trip this summer. And Dan Schachner is a longtime advocate for dog rescue and dog fostering and has refereed the Puppy Bowl for nearly a decade. And he's joining us now this morning from New York to talk about some great pet-friendly road trip ideas that we can enjoy this summer. Dan, where are you? I want to, there you, oh, I almost didn't recognize you without the black and white referee shirt.
I've got it underneath.
Okay, very good. So you've got a little Yorkie there. I know it's easier to travel with small dogs, but I'm curious to hear how you want us to make the trip nicer with a pooch along.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, as a Puppy Bowl ref, I foster a lot of dogs and help them find forever homes. The way this all came about was I had to foster a dog that was coming up from Puerto Rico and being flown up. They have a big overpopulation problem down there, and I met him up at the airport, but he was being flown to New Jersey and his forever home was in Massachusetts. Well, that's a 5-state trip, had to be taken in a couple of days, so I offered to do the transport. I turned to Orbitz for help. Them and Dollar Car Rental were able to provide but not just transportation but accommodation along the way. He hung out in my house for a little while with my kids, and then we hit the road the very next morning, and we hit, they call it the Beast Coast Road Trip, because you hit the Connecticut shoreline, you hit Newport, Rhode Island, you eat some lobster, you do some hikes, you go to Cape Cod, and you finish up in Boston. It was a really lovely way for this dog to get to know the mainland and to sort of get pampered and get ready for his forever home. So by the time we arrived right outside of Boston and he met his forever home, we'd had a really lovely, stress-free, there he is meeting his family. We had a really lovely, stress-free experience, and it was just great for all concerned. So I do recommend it. I recommend checking out orbitz.com/dog-friendly-road-trips because they do have routes for anybody, no matter where you are in the country.
Well, I'm surprised. 3 out of 4, you know, because sometimes you think it is a hassle to find out if the place has accommodations for dogs. And just the driving alone, you said a 5-state trip, I mean, it's fun to get on the destination to get out of the car, but while you're traveling, that can be a real challenge. How did you manage that?
Yes, it can. It's important to know your dog's temperament and breed. If you've got a more chill dog like Tully here, you know, they can take a little bit longer in the car without stops. But if you've got a more active dog, maybe you've got a husky or a lab or a boxer, and they need to get out more, well, in that case, you're going to have to build in those exercise breaks. So it really is about planning, and preparation is key. Make sure your dog is safe, harnessed, secured in the car, because if they're safe, you're going to be safe. You'll be less distracted. Make sure they have everything they need, their food, their water. It's the summertime. Make sure your dog is cool. If you've got a brachycephalic dog, like those squash-nosed pugs or bulldogs, remember, they're going to get overheated a little bit easier. They may have breathing problems. So again, know your dog. Talk to your vet beforehand, especially if it's a long trip. Plan accordingly. Build in the breaks. Bring all the stuff that they need from home. And yeah, check out those dog routes, because those routes are going to tell you not just dog tolerant places, but dog friendly places. And there's a big difference, right? Because there's a place that just says dogs are okay versus a place that welcomes dogs and caters to dogs. And that's why this site and this resource has been so valuable.
I'm looking at your map here. Midwoof for the Midwest here. What spots did you like in the Midwest?
Yes. Yeah, well, in Midwest, you can start at Belmont Harbor Dog Park, which is in Chicago. It's got that nice, you know, area for dogs along the beach. You can stop in Porter, Indiana, at the Dunes National Park. Kalamazoo is another stop along the way. By the way, these are all dog-friendly stops where the dogs can go either leashed or off-leash. You have to check, but each one of them will. And then ends up in Cleveland, which is a great little stop. This, by itself, is a 3-day trip. Because you're building in all the breaks and the overnights, but you can modify that, again, according to your dog and their breed, their temperament, their needs. You can modify that to fit your schedule.
Dan Schachner, it was great talking to you, and happy trails next time you're traveling. Thanks again.
Thank you very much.
All right, you guys take care from New York.